Brett Summers was the youngest national champion in the history of the United States. How old were you, first of all?
16 years old.
And who did you beat?
I beat, in the finals, I beat, let me guess who I beat.
I'm talking about the open division. Men, 26 years old, 27.
Oh, I beat Claudel Atkins, two-time Golden Gloves champion. He was like 26 years old. I mean, I was 16 years old and I feared nothing, didn't have any knowledge of who was what, just that I could fight. That's what I came there for.
You're originally from Seattle. The late, great Emanuel Steward spotted you, brought you to Kronk. How did a kid from Seattle, how did you blend in Kronk? How did you survive in there?
There was no blending in. They were all out for me in Detroit. They all came as hard as they could.
No shortage of sparring partners.
No. And here's another story. I was there, and Hector Camacho used to come into the gym to spar. He came to Kronk Gym, Escott is what it was called, to spar with us. We come in the first day, he doesn't know me and nobody. First thing he said, I want you white boy, I want you. Kept hollering, I want you white boy. I'm like, let me go, man. He's like, no, you can't do it. No, you can't do it. I said, okay. It's a month later, he fights. I'm like, wow, that's Hector Camacho. I didn't know who he was. I said, that guy's good, right? So he comes back again. Here he comes again. It's 6 months later or something. He's doing it again. They let us spar, right? We get in there. I've never been hit so fast in my life.
Wow.
That guy is speed lightning, man. He hit me so fast. I put my hands up, right? I'm going at him. Now he's cheap-shotting me. He's head-butting me. He's elbowing me. I got all mad. I head and armed him, tossed him in the ring, head and arm onto the canvas. His manager jumps in. Billy Squires, or I can't remember his name, jumps in there. Manager jumps in, and they break us apart.
That's
Guess
hilarious.
What? After that, he shook my hand and never gave me a problem, never called me white boy again.
You got your respect.
And we got along. That's
what was it like to train with Emanuel? And who else was at the gym at the time when you were there? What are the big names?
They were all there. Tommy Hearns, Milton McCrory, David Braxton, Leon Spinks was there later on. And they were all there. Mike McCallum came in and sparred. Everybody was there. Stevie McCrory.
Sounds like
every
like
one of them.
Legendary, like a Hall of Fame going on over there.
Yeah, that's
how did they train back then? What was the routine like for young fighters watching this?
There was no joke when you got in that gym. That gym was, I'm guessing, 80 to maybe 100 degrees. I mean, it was hot. I mean, I'm from Washington. It's not as hot, but it was a hot gym. You got in there, it was a dirty, muggy, fighting atmosphere. I mean, it's like what everybody says, how hot and how humid it is in there. And then you get in the ring and your opponent's in your face. I mean, it was just unreal how...
Brett, what's the best advice you ever got from Emanuel Steward, boxing-wise?
How about, not the best advice, but the advice was, you better get a job. Right in the corner, in the middle of the fight, you better get a job if you don't start beating this kid.
And what happened?
I knocked the kid out the next round.
What was your record as a, did you turn pro eventually?
Yes, I won 22 straight at one point and was rated 11th in the world.
That's pretty awesome.
And ended up 28 wins, 3 losses, 1 draw.
If you could fight anyone that you didn't fight in your era, who would be your Pacquiao or your Mayweather? Who would be the one?
Who would I want to fight? Believe it or not, my teammate Jimmy Paul.
That would be the fight.
Who was the lightweight champion of the world at that time.
The lightweight division right now, actually, the featherweight is very, very popular. You have Lomachenko, you have Walters, Mares, Evgeny Gradovich. You have. Do you follow boxing currently?
Yes, I do.
Who do you like? Lomachenko is, I think, one of the best. Only 4 fights, already a world champion. Him against, let's say, Nicholas Walters from Jamaica.
I'm going with Jamaica, Walters.
Walters, he's strong.
Kid stuff. He fights, that's my style. Aggressive, strong, come right ahead.
Absolutely. And who's your favorite fighter in the world today from the active guys?
I would say my favorite fighter would have to be Sugar Ray Leonard. I got 76. I was so close to making the 76 Olympic team, it was ridiculous.
That would have been sick.
He's a friend of mine to this day, Ray Leonard.
And what do you want people to know about Emanuel Steward? He passed away, I think, 2 years ago recently?
Emanuel Steward was one of the kindest men you'll meet. I mean, he was hardcore when it came to fighting. No, pulled no punches, straightforward, but very generous, very generous.
Absolutely. There you have it. Stay tuned. EsNewsReport.com. Melissa Back reporting.